Hi students, Van der Hoff factor from solutions. Okay, let's start the session. Suppose take a solution, any solution. In a solution there is solute and solvent. Okay, in a mixture there is solute and a solvent. If actually first you need to know the four colligative properties. I already uploaded a video on that. Four colligative properties. You know what? These colligative properties depends upon this number of solute particles. Okay? Suppose if this solute is again two types, that is whether it is electrolyte or non-electrolyte. Electrolyte means that compound in solution will dissociate. It will dissociate. Suppose take example as NaCl. NaCl will be dissociate to Na plus Cl minus. And this comes in electrolyte. For non-electrolyte, that compound, take example urea. Urea will not dissociate in the solution. It will remain as it is. So for this we don't use Van't Hoff factor. So for this there is no Van't Hoff factor. Why no Van't Hoff factor? Because here I value is 1. Van't Hoff factor is denoted by I. But for this electrolyte there is Van't Hoff factor. You need to calculate that Van't Hoff factor. Okay, to get this colligative properties. So let me discuss the trick here. See here, suppose a compound like NaCl, I am writing the general one, AnBm. This compound is an electrolyte. Assume it as electrolyte. Okay, example I am telling you. And you have to find the Van't Hoff factor. This is for 100% dissociation, students. Okay, for 100% dissociation. I is equal to, ma'am, what is this 100% dissociation? This compound in the solution will completely dissociate. Okay, it will completely dissociate. What is the Van't Hoff factor here? Trick is N plus M. That's it. N plus M. This undergoes dissociation. Okay, this undergoes dissociation. Suppose XA will dissociate, associate to AX. Here also I will give examples, you don't need to worry. Here I value will be 1 upon reactance coefficient. Take reactance coefficient X. That's it. You have done the trick and you are going to solve all the problems in an easy manner. Again remember this. This is only for 100% dissociation. Okay. So let's solve the questions. See, I will give examples also. Okay. For electrolytes, I am giving NCRT examples. Electrolytes, NCRT examples are like NaCl, okay, AgCl, MgCl2, CaCl2. This will dissociate. And for this association, most of the examples are acids, CH3COOH. This will dissociate to, it means this will dissociate in benzene solution. Okay, in benzene solution it will associate, in the sense it will form a dimer. Okay, it will form a dimer. If trimer is there, 1/3. If dimer is there, 1/2. That's it. Okay, please read the first question. They asked which of the molar solution have High freezing point. High freezing point. It is a freezing point is a colligative property. You also need to know the colligative properties formulas. Freezing point. Delta Tf is equal to Kf into molality into multiply the Van 't Hoff factor in case of electrolytes. That's it. Okay. See, aluminium sulfate. Al2SO43. Right. So for this, it will dissociate. 2 + 3 = 5. That's it. And for second one, KBr, potassium bromide. K + Br - 1 + 1 = 2. So for this, I value is 2. Barium chloride, BaCl2. For this, I value is 1 + 2 = 3. Okay, and for urea, I value is 1. I already discussed urea is a non-electrolyte. For non-electrolyte, I value will be 1. So here same molal solution. So this will depend upon I value, right? It will depend upon I value. Which of the following has more I value? See, aluminium sulfate has high value. Next, barium chloride. Next, potassium bromide. Next, urea. So A is greater than B is greater than C is greater than D. That's it. Please read the second question. Which of has maximum vapor pressure, osmotic pressure? Pi is equal to MRT. Examples, sum of electrolytes and sum is non-electrolyte. For electrolyte, it will depend on I, right? I. So, MgCl2. Here, I value is 3. Here, I value is CH3COOH will dissociate to form a dimer. So, I is 1 by 2. I already discussed now that 1 by X is the trick. And this will not dissociate. It is a non-electrolyte. This will dissociate. I is equal to 2. So, here pi value will depend upon I. Because same temperature. R value is same. Universal gas constant. And M is 4 all the 4 options are 1 molar. So, which of the following is high? So, A is greater than D is greater than C is greater than B. That's it. And see this question. Here they asked the boiling point. And you know that delta TB is KB into M into what I. So check the I value. Here I value is 2 + 1 = 3. Here I value is 2. Sucrose and glucose, they will not dissociate. So I value is 1. And you also need to check what is this 1%. Maybe it is, this is molality, right? Molality means number of moles dissolved in 1 kg of solvent. So it may be, I think so, weight by weight. So here, whatever, this is also equal, right? So it will always depend upon I. So which of the following is high value? A is greater than C. Here they asked which of the following has. So this is the correct option. So thank you for watching. Here see, A is greater than C is greater than B and D. Both having same 1-1 values, then it will depend upon the molality also. Here I didn't discuss the hard problems. In the next video, I will discuss some of the tough problems so that this will become a cakewalk for you. Thank you for watching this video. Here you need to check the molality also, but here same percentages are given, so no need to check that. And they asked that highest one. They didn't ask us to write the order, okay?